Hello learners, I again welcome you in my YouTube channel Metamorphosis, and I am quite elated that you are giving good response and you are liking and you are just pushing through all the topics, and you are also putting forth your demands. And one of the demand I am taking today, that many of the subscribers asked to deliver a lecture on topic adjective, and particularly student wanted my grammar lecture because they are I try to infuse innovation in my grammar teaching. So let's start adjective part 1 because it's a very good topic from the point of view of all competitive exams, whether bank, PO, to understand the fundamentals, whether it is lecturer or LT exams, or whether for the purpose of the interview of lecturers. So today I will introduce adjective and the fundamental aspects of the adjective, and next time I will take the errors, what kind of errors actually come there. So let's start. So let's not start actually. Let me narrate a story which is quite interesting. There was this little child, and he was trying to crawl, and this time he was trying to stand up, and one fine day he stood up. When he stood up, suddenly a wave of pleasure just went through the whole house, and the father and mother, they were quite elated. Mothers took some pictures that he has started walking. Father came happily at room, but what started happening? This child has started disturbing a lot to mother, and sometimes he was just breaking this thing, sometimes he was disturbing with the household works of the mother. So mother was fed up with the child. So when father comes at evening, so mother says, please take him outside because I am quite fed up. So father says, okay, I am taking. And father takes him outside, and mind that students, children are very curious by nature. The moment you think, you imagine that he is coming out first time in his life out, and the moment he just happened to see a car, he says, daddy, what is that? So father says, my dear child, father is very good, intelligent one, class 1 officer. He wants to make his child also. He says, my dear child, this is a car. It has 4 wheels. It runs with the help of engine and petrol or diesel. And when he was explaining with his blah, blah stuff, the child has started seeing a cow. And he says, father, what is that? Father says, this is cow. It is a pet animal. It gives milk. Then again, one thing, father, what is that? Oh my God, this is a very difficult situation. Now the father thinks that, okay, let me take him to some place where nothing is there to ask, not more than 1, 2, 3 things. So he takes him to the park, and in the park, when he was relaxed, and child suddenly says, father, yes, what is that? And the father sees there is a bird. So father start again that stuff, explaining, this is a bird, it flies up in the sky, it eats insect, and it is small in size. And the night is there, and father comes back. The next day, again in the park, again father relaxes, again child sees a bird, and he says, father, yes, what is that? Oh, come on, that's a bird, I told you. No, this is not a bird, bird was yesterday one. Come on, this is a bird. No, father, this is not a bird. I am saying it's a bird, not a bird. Bird, chatak. There was a slap, and the child started weeping. Where is the problem? From here start the concept of adjective. The problem was that the father actually showed him yesterday that was a black bird, and father never told him that birds are of many colors. And today what the child was watching over there, it was a red bird, so he was confused. So now here comes the concept of adjective, that very quality or that very word which distinguishes between two things, which is actually used to distinguish, to create a difference between two things, that is called adjective. We are generally confined by a simple definition, ki koi bhi cheez jis kisi ki visheshta batlata, to that is adjective. No, when adjective is being talked about, that is about the difference between two things, one word which is creating a difference between two things. So now, for example, suppose I say, bring me the red book from the home, from the house. So he will go there and he will bring. How was he able to bring the exact book? Because other books were not red. It was quite, you know, distinguished from other books. So that's why. And suppose there are so many red books, then he will demand another adjective. He will say, which one red? I will say, that one red where the edge is broken. So again, I have introduced one difference and that differentiating word, and that is adjective, that broken edge. So whenever we are differentiating something, whenever we are trying to differentiate one thing from other, that we need an adjective. They are called ornaments of language. They are very important. And Arundhati Roy uses it quite dexterously. Now, let's come to the last part of this part one. Suppose you go for a blood test and you are trying to test it for malaria. When it is positive, it means signs of malaria are there, signs. So whenever we talk of a quality, suppose we say black, we talk of a quality which is actually there in one thing, which is present there, by which we are differentiating, that means that quality is positive in somebody. So that is actually positive degree in. So just by introducing a quality to differentiate is a positive degree. So black is positive degree. Suppose this one and this two both are involved with the quality. So these both are being compared. So this is called comparative. Positive and comparative. But when the, so comparative can be written more black or blacker. But when we need to the superlative, it means jet black. And this is the superlative degree, which we say that black, most black, most black. So after that, no other thing exists. So whenever we use superlative degree, suppose good is a positive, better is a comparative, and best is superlative. Before each and every superlative degree, we always keep the definite article the. Otherwise, it will never be a superlative degree. So we have come to know that what is the fundamental of adjective, what is positive degree, what is comparative degree, what is superlative degree, and we have come to know the ins and outs of all these things. And at last, I would like to tell you, all those who are preparing for competitions, particularly for grammar based competitions, so they must know that in positive there are so less errors, nobody is going to ask from this. The same, only 1% or 2% error comes from the superlative. We need to master, or we need to command vice like grip, have maintained vice like grip over this comparative degree, where 5 to 6 rules actually are there, which are based upon all those errors which are coming into the competitive exams. So dear friends, keep watching my grammar classes. They are always infused with quite innovativeness, and my grammar classes are always full of students, and all those who are already taking classes in other institute, they also come and join my grammar classes in order to just clear their fundamentals and to have a command over the error section. So I will come with the second part in next video. Thank you. Till then, have a nice day.